Richard Chamberlain from the Chamberlain's restaurants up in Addison, the seafood place, which we love.
Thank you.
Steak and Chop House, which we also love.
We also love. And you're here to talk about Oktoberfest.
Oktoberfest, yeah.
Oh, you've even got your bib on.
Yeah, I do.
Ready to eat, huh? So tell us, you're going to be there preparing some delicious food.
Exactly. This is our fourth year to do our Chamberlain's Brauhaus. And basically, it's really cool. It's inside the tent. We seat about 200 people per seating. And we serve just classic Bavarian and Oktoberfest style food. One of the highlights this year, we're starting with a soup. It's a Bavarian soup where we make a house-made Bavarian ham. And of course, you have to have cabbage and of course, onions. Mm-hmm. And then this is just simmered in a house-made stock that we make with smoked pork. And then we finish it with carrots and potatoes. Of course, every good German soup has to have lots of carrots
you
and
bet.
Potatoes. But gives it a lot of great color. And then this is some of the beautiful smoked pork that we've cooked real slowly for 48 hours. And then, of course, some of the favorites out there every year are the sausages.
Oh,
and
yeah.
We
bet.
Throw down with beautiful smoked bratwurst. We have the veal bratwurst. And then a really interesting this year called Grobe sausage. It's a classic Bavarian sausage with a little spice of nutmeg in it, which gives it just a tiny, tiny bit. Really beautiful. And then Polliner braised pork shoulder. So we cook this real slowly in fresh herbs, Polliner beer, and then of course you have to have braised cabbage. This cabbage is braised with local Kobe beef bacon.
Oh my goodness.
Is that insane?
You know how to do it right.
Look at that. Yeah, so
that meat was falling apart as you pulled it up. That's like perfect, right?
It's just so tender. It just falls off on your fork. And then to finish this soup, we have some sliced pork in the bowl here.
Yeah, look at that. There's sliced pork in the bottom.
Right.
And then you're just putting I would never think to do that. Then put the soup right on top.
Correct. Just right over the top. And then, of course, that beautiful, rich broth. It's going to go perfect this weekend. Mm-hmm. And then you have to have a strudel for dessert for Oktoberfest.
If you insist.
I know, right? So we're doing a cherry strudel with a port wine and cherry sauce over the top.
Wow.
So a lot of beautiful food. There will be a lot of people out there this weekend.
And everybody's in a good mood for Oktoberfest because we're finally starting to get a little bit cooler weather, and there's beer.
That's it, and good food. That's all you need.
It's truly one of the best Oktoberfest, I think, probably in the world, next to Munich. And but you're right, people are happy, and it's just a real festive event.
How many days before do you start preparing to serve this many people?
We start planning a couple of months out,
because
there's you know, we serve over 1,000 people over Thursday, Friday, and Saturday just in our Brauhaus area. And so there's a lot of preparation. Then we start cooking. We started cooking Monday of this week, kind of getting our prep ready. And it's a big deal. Our chef Lan Nickens kind of organizes all that. And but we're talking about, you know, hundreds of gallons of soup and hundreds of pounds of pork and sausages.
Oh, there you go. Wow. Free tomorrow and Sunday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, in Addison. We have more information and links so you can find it, not get lost. On Fox4News.com.
We'll be right back.